Are you excited, folks? Are you sure you're excited? I can't hear you. They can't hear you in back. Yes, keep it up. Keep it up. Yes. Oh. All right. Welcome to another episode of Iron Science Teacher. How are you feeling, audience? Yeah. I am your host. I'm out of breath because we have been so excited, working so hard because it's our last Iron Science Teacher episode of the summer. So do you feel that? Do you feel the out of breathness that I have, the exhaustion? Because you know what? My name is Jessica Glamorous Parker, and it's hard to be this glamorous on the stage when I'm gonna bring up four amazing middle school, high school teachers to cook up some science. Before I do that, I wanna remind you, we are broadcasting live throughout not just California, not just the nation, but the world! Amazing. So what in the world is Iron Science? It is based on a fun 1990s Japanese cooking show called Iron Chef, where they gave chefs a secret ingredient and they had to cook up some magical, incredible meal based on that secret ingredient. So we put an exploratorium spin on that idea. And we're gonna have these amazing four middle school and high school teachers cook up incredible science classroom activities using a secret ingredient. Why do we do this? Well, we love the science of everyday things, and of course we love to applaud great teaching. Do you? Yeah. Ow, of course you do, of course you do. Thank you. But I should share that the secret ingredient is not so secret to our contestants. They've known about it. You don't, so it's okay. We'll have a big reveal, we'll let you know. But the secret ingredient is inspired by a summer exhibition we have going on here called Inflatable, with gigantic air-filled art throughout the entire museum. So check it out if you can. All right, audience, I need your help. You know why? Because I need you all to tell me who should be crowned Iron Science Teacher Champion. And I need you to do so through cheering, yelling, stomping, screaming, clapping. Can you do that for me? Yeah. Oh, that's amazing. So let's meet our contestants. They are science teachers spending 3 weeks with us here at the Summer Institute, and they are representing the middle school and high school institutes. First up is Jake Pozecki. Jake, yes.
Representing.
Here we go. Jake, where do you teach and what do you teach?
So I teach integrated science, engineering, and makerspace at MetWest High School in Oakland, California.
Whoa, Oakland! All right, next up representing the Middle School Institute is Laurie Purdy McFadden. Do you wear that dress every day or just for Iron Science Teacher?
I think I wear it pretty often throughout the school year. Cause like, come on, this is pretty sweet.
Yes, that's amazing. All right, where do you teach and what do you teach?
So I teach sixth grade science here in San Francisco Unified School District.
What, San Francisco! All right, another high school institute teacher coming up, Riversa. River, what do you teach and where do you teach?
I teach ninth grade biology and physiology and anatomy at McAteer at SF. Actually, the academy at McAteer at SF.
All right, another representative from San Francisco. And batting cleanup, we have David Monjanje. Where and what do you teach?
I teach physics and environmental science at the Oakland High School.
The Oakland High School, amazing. Contestants, are you ready to help reveal our secret ingredient to the audience? Okay. Contestants, based on these ingredients, I need you to cook up some science activities. Audience, I need your help. Are you ready to see the secret ingredients? All right, here we go. The secret ingredients are rope, cord, yarn. What are they possibly gonna do? All right, contestants, on your mark. Get set, make some science, go! Give them a round of applause as they prep. I have no idea what is happening behind me. All I know is that these teachers, over 50 of them, have been here at the Summer Institute for 3 weeks, and today is the last day. Oh, collective sigh. So these amazing teachers spent quality time away from their loved ones and family and friends to be with us, and so that's so wonderful because not only do we love teaching, but we also love science, and this is one of the best places to actually grow as a professional. So, I know they're exhausted, but I think they might be ready to actually get going. Are you ready, contestants? No, they're not. Well, let's let them go anyway. Doesn't matter, here we go. All right, if so, contestants, let's check in on what Jake is doing. So he seems to be doing something with some rope and some wooden dowels. Kind of looks like a rolling pin. He seems to be slightly confused. I'm not sure. Yeah, he's totally confused. It's okay, audience. I think you'll be able to figure it out in a second. Jake loves to help students not only have opportunities to make real things with technology, and so maybe he might be helping us figure out something with a kind of an older form of technology. We will see. Okay, thank you, Jake. Let's check in on Lori. What is she doing? Lori is a sixth grade teacher who is doing something with some yellow, looks like string. There's some nuts attached to that. She seems to be unwinding something. She loves it when she's able to work with students who find science boring and provide that spark and inspiration to make it fun. I think she's definitely going to be bringing some sort of spark and inspiration to some yellow string today. Yes. Thank you, Lori. Appreciate that. Let's check in on River. What is happening? He's doing something. He has three hands now. He has three hands and some pink yarn, and he seems to be all tangled up. River loves to actually, when teaching biology, he loves that students are funny, curious, and always keeping him on his toes because they are very forgiving. So I think he is going to find ways to pique our curiosity today when it comes to that pink yarn. I am not sure what he's going to do, but it's going to be fantabulous. Don't you think so, audience? Yes, okay. And our last contestant, let's check in on David and see what he is up to. He's got some yellow/orange cord. He seems to be listening to something. Making it move. Fascinating. He's an environmental science and physics teacher, and he loves to combine science with art and music. So maybe he's going to give us some musical inspiration today. I'm certain he'll be able to do that for us. All right, we have about 30 seconds, contestant. Use this time wisely before we wrap up and get going. Audience, let's give him a round of applause. Right, I think they're already ready. They're running off the stage, folks, because they're so ready. It's perfect. Why don't we give another round of applause as they leave together? Nice work, nice work. All right. At this time, let's call up our first contestant. You know him and love him. Here he is, Jake Pazecki.
Okay. Don't tell anyone. But I found a secret exhibit at the Exploratorium, okay? I was walking back into the other wing where all of the mice are and the bacteria are, and you know they're growing that egg without its shell, right? I kept walking and I found something incredible. Don't tell anyone. Radioactive spiders, okay? I was with my friend Julia. We were walking and she got bit and turned into Spider Woman. Isn't that crazy? Wait, do you guys want to meet Spider Woman?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, so here, how about we count on the count of three, we'll go 1, 2, 3, Spider Woman, maybe she'll show up, okay? So 1, 2, 3, Spider Woman! There she is, folks!
There she is, folks!
All right, so Julia, she got web powers, and she can climb on walls now, which is amazing, right? And she also got super spidey strength, which is so cool. Do you all want to see her use her spidey strength?
Yeah!
Is that okay with you? Okay, awesome. Can I call up my volunteers that I planned earlier to come up and show off Julia's spidey strength?
All right, let's introduce those volunteers. Here they come from the High School Summer Institute. Come on down. Tell us your name and what you teach and where you're from.
John Allen, Physics, San Jose.
Awesome, thank you. How about you?
Albert Hill, Physics, Oakland.
Okay, I don't know what's in store, but have some fun. There you go.
All right, so here's what we're gonna do. John, if you can come over here. So I'm gonna give John this stick, and I'm gonna give Albert this stick. And we're gonna see if, in a little game of tug of war, who's stronger. Albert and John, who they're pretty, if we had to compare sizes, who would you say is bigger, these two or Julia over here? Right? Albert, here, let me get a little bit closer. Okay, cool. So Julia, if you wanna come over here. Yeah, so go ahead. So Albert and John, they're a little bigger than Julia, right? So do you, like, the question is, do you think that Julia can pull these two men together in this act of tug of war?
No.
Yeah. No way, right? Well, I know you're all at the end of your rope, but we're about to find out. So let's see. Let's do a countdown. 3, 2, 1, pull! Whoa. What is happening? Do you guys see the way that these two men cannot pull apart this string when Julia is pulling on it? Oh, they're trying as hard as they can, and they can't do it. All right, that's amazing. Let's give a round of applause. So, Julia, this is so amazing. Your Spidey powers are so powerful. That's really, really cool. Wait, what's that? You didn't get bit by a radioactive spider? You're not really Spider Woman? You use science to pull these two together? That's amazing and so clever. Use the science of pulleys to pull these two together. Do you know what a pulley is, folks? A pulley, here, and let's pull this apart. I think we don't want to string along the audience. We should explain how the science works. All right, so if we just had one of these wraps around, right? So we just did this once. Let's see if Julia could pull them together. Let's see. Let's try. See, it's a little harder, right? She's having a harder time. But as we add more pulleys, more wraps of string around it, it becomes easier for Julia to pull them together, right? And that's because every time that we add a new loop, it cuts the force in half that Julia needs to pull a big object together, or in this case, these two big objects together, right? And so next time that you are out looking at the big cranes and you're like, wow, they're using spider magic, not, it's pulleys. Let's give them a round of applause, everyone. Thank you so much.
Thank you. All right, I'll take some.
Thank you, volunteers.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Jake, for showing us the power of pulleys. All right. Next up, we have Lori Purdy McFadden.
Matilda has this ability, sorry. So I teach sixth grade, and I was really inspired by this thing back when I was a kid, and I still really love it today. And it's Matilda. It's this book, it's a movie, and Matilda is able to move things with her mind. She starts with just like a little Cheerio. You guys know what Cheerios are. Your breakfast cereal. She moves a Cheerio, and then she gets better, and she's able to move books, and they like dance around the room, and then she gets even better, and she can make herself pancakes. I want to make myself pancakes, right? Like, how fun would that be? You just get to sit there and say, mind, make me pancakes. And it works. Like, things start moving in the air, and they're mixing, and they're cooking. Pretty cool. So, I have this contraption that I built for my classroom. And I was looking at it one day, and I thought, I bet I could work to make this move with my mind. So, I've been practicing. And to prove that it's my mind, I'm gonna have my predetermined volunteer come help me. Yamie, come on up. Give her a round of applause, everyone. Come on, Yamie! Okay. So, Yamie, do you wanna tell us a little bit about yourself? Maybe like where you're from, what you teach?
Sure, I'm Yamie. I teach seventh grade science in Chicago.
Woo! Windy City, Windy City. So she'd be good for this, right? So, Yamie, I want you to show the audience, like, I'm gonna hold this on the ends.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna talk really loud.
I'm gonna hold the
mic in your mouth. There we go.
So, Yamie's gonna prove to you that there's no like wires attached, like there's no string between me and this. Like, can you just show them? Like, it's just here. Just string,
no string up here,
some bolts, some nuts, like, right? There's nothing there.
No trickery.
No trickery.
I trust you.
It's my mind. That's the only thing that's happening. It's magic. So, I'm gonna have Yamie pick one of these nuts to move with my mind. She's gonna pick one, and then I'm gonna move it for you. So, Yamie, will you pick one?
Yeah.
Oh, we better pick a good one. Pick
I
a good one.
This one.
Okay. Do you think it's a good one? Yeah.
That one.
Yeah. Round of applause. That's a good one, right? Okay. So, I'm gonna move it with my mind. I gotta give all my concentration. I gotta focus really hard, really, really hard. I really appreciate you guys hanging around with me today. Let's see, is the mic working now? Can you hear me? All right, I gotta focus. Oh, I don't know, Yamie, is anything changing?
Wow.
Is it starting to change?
I see them moving, but right? There's nothing attached to you. I trust that you're doing this just with your mind. Wait a second.
And what's starting to happen now?
Hold on. I see the one I picked is moving a little more than the rest.
Hmm. What about now?
I think it's moving all by itself, Lori.
It's pretty close, right?
Yeah, that's pretty good.
It's pretty good.
That's pretty
right?
good. That's all right. pretty good.
So just to prove I'm still doing it with my mind, Yamie, can you pick one more?
Yeah, let's say maybe this little one here.
Okay,
like
we're gonna aim for this little one, all right? So here we go, all with my mind. I'm focusing. This takes so much mind power. Oh, I'm really close. It's getting closer. Well, I got the one next to it going.
I see it.
Can I get the next one going?
Oh, I think you can.
Oh, here we go.
I see it happening.
Right? It's closer?
Yeah, it's
Do
closer.
Can you see that, maybe?
Closer?
Kind of? Ooh, what's that? Ooh, right there! Yeah!
I think you're just like Matilda.
Ooh! Now, to prove that I'm actually doing this with my mind, I'm gonna hand this to Yamie and have Yamie try it. Yamie, here you go.
I don't think I'm magic, though.
Oh, well, we're gonna find out.
Okay.
So, Yamie, can you move this one? Here, I'm gonna stop them all. Give you a fair advantage. All right, so this one right here. Can you move that one for us? Just think about it really hard. Concentrate.
Move.
Can you move it? Oh, do you think that's gonna work? I don't know. No. Did that one move right here?
No.
Did it move? No! So, what do we think? Am I moving this with my mind? Yeah. No! Who said no? Let me see that hand. Who said no? Brilliant. You're right. I'm not moving it with my mind. So, I'm using this thing in science called resonance, where you can get something in the world out and around you to move. When it hits the perfect frequency or the right movement, it moves a lot, and everything else kind of stands still and stops. So, as I stand here, I'm able to shake this just right, sometimes, not always perfect, where you get one of these bolts or nuts to move a lot. So, to prove what I'm talking about, because this one's really hard to use, I made another model so that Yamie can actually demonstrate it for you. So, this is a bunch of different colored rings. Blue, green, orange, yellow, red. Yamie,
okay,
is gonna shake this and show you when one of them moves. So let's aim for like, I don't know. Why don't you shake this and see what you can get to move? They all kind of move it first, right?
How do I shake it? This
Just
way?
Shake.
Anyway.
Yeah. So you see they're all moving, right? They're all moving. Now shake a little harder. Oh, which one's really moving now? Kind of the screen. Yeah. Now maybe a little harder. A little more. All right. Still green. Okay, maybe a little less. What if we go a little less? Oh, the green really likes it. She's a green person. She likes the green.
Green's my favorite color.
So a little less. Nice soft movements. Softer. Let's see. Maybe I'll help Amy out.
Yeah. You help me out.
Which one's moving now?
Slower. That's the key.
Yellow and red. Do you think I can get one to move on its own? Yeah. I don't know. Let's try. Oh. Where are we at now? Orange, right? And a little faster? Green,
yeah.
Right?
Okay,
so, resonance, you can get things in your world to move. You can get them to, yeah. Oh, see, Yamie's starting to get the hang of it. Ooh. So, I would invite you to notice things around your world and see, can you find their frequency? Can you find where they move on their own?
Maybe you can get it to be your mind, but I'm thinking it's more science. So, thank you so much.
All right, thank you, you two. Awesome, thank you so much. All right, next up from the High School Institute, we have River Sue. Come on up.
Hi, everybody. I am so glad to see all of you because you look like humans to me. And that means that we can do science here. You've seen strength, you've seen magic. Guess what? You all have a ton of strength and magic inside you. And I'm gonna show you three ways using just your own bodies. But for that, I'm gonna have some help. It's a little nervous being on stage and I need a sample human. Can I get my sample human? All right, thank you.
Here she comes. Tell us who you are, where do you teach, and what do you teach?
Hello, my name is Bianca, and I teach in Oakland, California, eighth grade science.
Yay!
And have you been human all your life?
Yeah.
All right, sure. I think you'll be okay. All right, so you're gonna help us out because we may have some viewers who don't have hands, but they also have lots of other features that we'll be examining, but if you could hold up your hand, maybe somebody in the audience can do it too. You can do it right where you're sitting. If you put your hand in your lap, right, what shape is it? Is it straight or curved? Can you tell me?
Curved.
Curved, right? That's a little hard. You can put it down. Right, why is it curved? Did you try to make it curved?
No.
You just kind of, are you sure you're not like pulling it curved this way?
No. No.
All right. Okay, can I ask you to try something?
Yes.
Maybe the audience can join us. Okay, if you lay your hand on your lap, and don't do it until it hurts, but keep pressing right here on your wrist, all the way down, as hard as you can to try to open your wrist. See if you can do it. As hard as you can before it starts to hurt, don't let it hurt. Can you open it? You're fighting against yourself, right? Are you trying to close your hand though?
No.
What's going on? Maybe there's like magic in there? I don't know. Well, I know that I have strings, so let me take out some models, right? I have three models today. I've got one that's Now, I've built this model of a hand because today I'd like to show you three different examples of how biology is a paradox. A paradox is when things are opposite in the same thing. You are both soft and strong, right? You grow really strong, but you're kind of squishy too. Turns out if you zoom all the way in and zoom all the way out, you've got hard and soft, you've got rigid and flexible in everything around you. And our first example is with your hand. Now, I've got this kind of sample hand right here, and if Bianca could put her hand right here. So we've got grown-ups who want to sound fancy. These are called carpals at the very bottom. You have seven of them. But here we've got these bones. And she's got bones right here, and these are rigid. You can't bend them, right? If you're trying to bend your finger, it doesn't really bend here. But you need to be able to grasp things. You need to be able to hold your pencil, your food. So what we've got are muscles, right? So you've got muscles that are like, hello. Maybe. I want to be a puppeteer. Right, so that's your muscles. But then what's going on here, right? Are they rebelling against you? Are you fighting your own body sometimes? Turns out you've got these little stretchy things called tendons. And it makes a lot of sense if you're climbing, you're grasping, or you're trying to hunt like a mastodon or something, to have your hands kind of here, right? Because if I'm grasping something and my hand is flat, oh, I've got to actually use my muscles. I've got to have hands. I've got to have food to power those hands. But if you've just got these rubber bands and they're stretching out, there's a lot of potential energy in there. You all have tons of potential when you just open and close your hands like that. Because your body's super efficient. And turns out there are these things called tendons that connect your muscle to your bone all over your body. Everywhere where you can bend, that's called a joint. You've got muscles connecting, you've got tendons connecting muscle to bone. Because if we didn't have tendons, kind of try holding that and then just pulling on that. Not a lot of fine control, right? But I've got tendons stabilizing myself. So now Right? Instead of going, you're going, hey there, how you doing? Right? It's good to see you. So here's where we have rigidity. We have strong, straight bones that don't bend. And we've got soft tendons and muscles. So let's keep on zooming in, right? We've got hands. You do hand stuff every day. You also walk around and stand every day. And I've got two models right here. So this is the first one. And if I could get my sample human to turn in that direction, you can actually feel these bones in the back of your head. So you've got seven tiny little cervical bones. This is your spinal cord. It's all your information goes up and down your body. So I'm gonna, Bianca's very kindly gonna turn so we can see. She's got seven cervical bones. See, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. She's got these intervertebral discs. So your bones are super hard because you're like, you're jumping up and down, pretty strong. I'm not like, bleh, right? I'm pretty strong. But then I don't want these bones to like hit each other. So I've got these squishy parts right in between. So I've got hard and soft. I've got hard and squishy. So when I'm bouncing, I'm not just bone. I'm going bounce, bounce, bounce. That's a lot more potential energy. So you've got all of this all the way down the body. So if Bianca bends over and then bends back up, she can still bend. But I can't really push down on her to get her to squash flat. And if you keep on zooming in down here, we get something that looks like this. Yeah, this is zooming in. And Bianca, what? Do you think I could pull this apart?
No.
It's pretty hard, right? Mm-hmm. Try taking one of these and tugging in that direction. Can you do that? Can you?
Sorry.
It's okay. Right, if somebody did that to you, do you think they would be able to break your back?
I hope not.
Right. Yeah. I'm hoping too. But turns out this is the structure for how you can bend, but still be super, super strong. And your body's doing that for you every single day. Sitting there right now, got your tush up here. That's your spine right now. Bend this way, bend that way, bounce. Right, you've got soft stuff. You've been super patient. I've got one last thing, and it's our most enhanced, most zoomed in. You're made of cells. Your cells look like this inside. Yeah, so a lot of the time in school, we learn about different kinds of ways to understand things. A lot of us, you know, in grade school might remember that a cell is made of cytoplasm. There's like gel inside. Turns out it's not actually jelly. It's easy to understand it as jello, but it's actually a super complex network of things that are shaped like these. So what I'm showing right here is what we call a buckyball. But it's super stable, but can I kind of move this around? Is it staying, right? You want your cells to have flexibility because you're flexible. You want to be able to be both strong and soft, depending on when you need to be. So let's see how strong this is, if you could hold that. This is pretty hard. Wow. But you're totally made of all of these, and you've got your mitochondria, your ribosomes, everything in there is suspended in this so that they all have support. And that's how every single one of you, down to your last cell, is made of both strong and soft. You are a harmony of all of these different opposites. And that's why I love biology. Thank you.
All right, round of applause, please, for River and Bianca talking about the hard and soft cells in your body and in life. All right, we have one last contestant, folks. Here we go. Please welcome from the High School Institute, David Mongiante.
Thank you very much. Hello, ladies and gentlemen.
Let's move some tables around.
Let's move some things while I talk to you guys.
String is really one of our oldest inventions. String is this really amazing thing that us as humans have created to do lots of things in the world around us. We can pull it tight and taut. We can make a bow out of it to shoot a deer. We can crumple it up into a ball and store it in a pouch. We can net it into woven fabric that we make clothing out of. String is a really wonderful thing, and we use it for these practical purposes for our survival. But us as humans, we are not simply survivalists. We don't simply seek to survive, we seek to thrive. And so today I'm going to be showing you and demonstrating for you how we can thrive as a human race. And one of the ways to do it is we often thrive by expressing ourselves, expressing how we feel, expressing how we think, expressing ourselves in ways that are not necessarily vocal or spoken, not necessarily in terms of writing, but often artistic. Today we're going to be investigating music and looking at how string and the properties, those interesting properties of string, can make the music in the world around us. So I have some helpers today that are going to be helping me on our journey through sound and music. And they're coming to us from Indonesia and Thailand, and they're here in this case. I think we're going to need a round of applause, though, just to get them out. They're very shy. So please, ladies and gentlemen, can I get a round of applause? Please, 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 round of applause. These are the professors. Oh, they're very shy, sorry. Professor Fro, and Professor Og. This is Professor Og and Professor Fro. Together, they're professors of sound and music. They are experts, and when I fail, they're going to take up the slack. So sound, music has many different properties, many different things that make music work and function for us. There is rhythm, of course. It is the beat that we hear in music. And that's a really important part of music, where we have the beat and the rhythm. It's what you dance to, it's what you tap your foot to. You can hear some rhythm. It's the rhythm of the music, and that's very important. And different cultures use different rhythms, and they use different timings as they create their music. And sometimes the rhythms are faster, sometimes the rhythms are slower, sometimes they're quieter. Sometimes they are louder. And sometimes also string, it's not just about the rhythm, it's not just about the speed, it's also about, sorry, what's that? What's that? Oh yeah, sorry. I'm super ahead of myself. I totally missed the most important part. We don't even know what sound is. We don't even know what sound is yet. Do I know what sound? Do you guys know what sound is? Let's figure it out together. Can everyone hum for me? As you're humming, take your hands and put them on your neck. Do you feel that? Do you feel your sound? The sound is the vibration of your vocal cords in your body. You're actually making sound and feeling the sound. Sound is vibrations. And those vibrations travel in something that we call waves. Waves are an interesting thing where they take sound and travel from place to place. The waves are moving in the air. And I have here something called the Wavematic 3000. The Wavematic 3000 is designed to show you the waves. And we can see it as I move it, and I'm in the way here. As I move it and touch it, I can change the waves and the shape. Ooh. And as I change the shape of the waves, they look different. But seeing, we say seeing is believing, but really seeing is not believing. Hearing is believing. Well, actually, really, smelling is believing. But we're going to stick with hearing is believing for this. And I have a special tool that I'm going to use today. It's this. This is a tool that allows us to pick up some of the sounds that are around us. So I'm going to take this pickup, and I'm going to put it near the Wavematic 3000. And I'm going to turn on this other device here. It's going to be annoying, I'm sorry. Oh my god, it's very loud. What we're listening to, though, is the Wavematic 3000. We're actually hearing the sound of the instrument playing right now. As I take this and I change the Wavematic 3000, let's listen carefully. That is so weird. That is so weird. So as I push it together, we can hear the sound gets lower. As I pull it apart, we can hear the sound gets higher. We call those pitch. Pitch is when we have a difference of the highness or lowness of a sound. I'm going to turn this off because it's a little bit annoying. I'm going to leave the Wavematic 3000 going for us. As I pull it, stretch it, the pitch seems to get higher. As I contract it, the pitch seems to get lower. Our professors want to say something, though. They're ready to tell us a little bit more, because I keep screwing this up, and I keep saying the wrong things in the wrong order. But the professors really know, and they wanted to tell you guys something. So let's listen very carefully to our professors. Professor Froh, what did you have to say? Very important point. Yes, thank you very much, Professor Froh. Professor Ogg, what was that? Very interesting. Did you guys understand that? Did you guys get that? I certainly understood. Let me try again. Let's hear it again. Let's hear it one more time. Oh my God, that's so important. Professor Froh is telling us that larger objects make deeper sounds. And Professor Ogg was telling us that smaller objects make higher sounds. That's super interesting. I think we can use that idea and this idea to make a thing. Let's make a thing together. So I have this string here, and I said that strings can be really useful for tools, but they can also make music. This string sounds beautiful. You can't really hear it. So what could I do? I could maybe stretch it. I could stretch this string just like I stretch this one to make that pitch a little bit higher. I have a handy glass bottle here with me that I can use to stretch this string. Let's see if I can get it to be nice and taut and stretched. Not my favorite. Okay. All right. But I can't really hear it yet. So let's add this pickup device back onto the string. And as I add the pickup device, remember the pickup, what it does is it can listen to the sounds as they're being made. And then just nail this in a little bit more. And this one in just a little bit more so that we can really hear what's going on. I'm sorry. Oh, you heard a thing. You know, I'm gonna just do it like this. Okay. Beautiful. And so let's turn on the pickup device and hear what we can hear. As I get tighter, the sound gets higher. As I move this piece of glass closer towards the bottle, closer to the pickup, the amount of the string that can vibrate gets shorter and shorter, and the sound gets higher and higher. Let's play it. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you learned something. Have a lovely day.
What? That was amazing. Thank you so much, David. We appreciate it. All right, folks. You have four amazing contestants that you need to decide on. Let's bring them back out, please. All four of them, come on, audience. Help them get out here. Jake was talking to Spider-Woman. They had a conversation, and I guess she's not coming back up.
She could if you want her to.
No, it's okay. I think she's done enough. Right, folks? She did a great job. Yes. All right, so let's summarize the amazing Ion Science teachers we saw today. Remember, Jake told us about the power of pulleys and the ability to have superhuman strength through science. All right. Lori talked to us about resonance and finding your frequency, and not only in science, but also in life as well. All right, thank you, Lori. River talked about the soft and strong parts of your body, not only your hands, but all the way into your cells as well. Awesome. And David talked about the art and science of music. Okay, so in order to make this totally objective, here we go. I have a sound level meter right here. Let me turn this on and test it out. Audience, let's see if this works. Can you give me your largest round of applause, please? Okay, audience, are you sure that was the loudest that you could do?
Yeah.
Okay, okay. Thank you very much. Let's see, what did you think about Jake?
Put on the table.
Oh. Okay, thank you so much. Let's go to Lori. All right, how about River? Okay, and how about David? All right, our champion for Iron Science Teacher is David! Thank you so much, David, we appreciate it. And this is our goodbye, our farewell song to 2018 Iron Science Teacher. But continue to go out and make the science and observe and explore the science of everyday things. And of course, applaud great teaching like we saw today. Thanks, everybody. See you next year.
Yeah, and the catalyst is letting Austin go free.